or rap, it's straight ahead. Statistics said it's Sam the Record Man. Videographer George Lagajanis and I checked it out.
Yes, I feel you feel this crazy. I never took that trip. I'd rather feel helpless as a breeze comes in. I never feel this dangerous.
The van thing is really great.
Yeah.
I mean, especially in writing the music and stuff, because you immediately have a sound. You know what I mean? Opposed to you use different musicians all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Then it never sounds the same, really, you know? And it's really good, you know? It's far from the Beatles' Hard Day's Night sort of mentality, but it's still a lot of fun, you know?
Yes.
The guys in the band handling the fact that you get a lot of attention based on, you know, the cute factor?
I don't know. They get a lot of attention too because of the Stevie Ray Vaughan factor, so it sort of balances out.
It all works out.
Yeah, it all works out.
Just let me be. I'm just living in a dream.
My name is Charlie. I put a record out in 86, called Pictures for Pleasure. And I small but quaint and comfortable studios. Much music, probably in 86 or 87.
It's a long time ago. That's 5 years ago. Man.
Yeah, a long time.
And you, sir, your name is?
Thoreau Abraham Hall.
And when did we meet you?
And, last time I was here, I was with the Fabulous Thunderbirds.
Oh, fantastic. So now, how did this Archangels band start?
It was a fluke.
Yeah?
It really was by accident. It started like, I think, how most musicians start playing in the first place is for the love of the music. And we just sort of said, hey, let's do some gigs for fun, you know, have fun with it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you guys used to hang out together?
We met when we were 14, and we've both known Chris and Tommy, drummer and bass player, for most of our lives, really.
So Chris and Tommy are the rhythm section for Double Trouble,
yes.
Which is Stevie Ray Vaughan's band. Interesting that people write about your band. They say we found the next Stevie Ray Vaughan. There seems to be like a search, someone to replace him.
Yeah. I don't think you're going to be capable of finding another Stevie Ray Vaughan. And I also don't think that's necessarily what we're trying to do, you know.
It's not what we're trying to do.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a misconception that, you know, we're this great new blues band. But if that's happened, it's completely by accident because we're not trying to be a blues band. We have that influence, and we play rock and roll, and obviously that comes through, you know, that's where it's derived from.
When I listen to the record, I think of Jimi Hendrix and I guess you can call them almost dinosaur bands from the 60s and 70s, but
oh,
I don't
so
mean
kind.
That in, I don't mean that in a negative way, pardon me, but I just mean good old-fashioned, straight-ahead, Deep Purple.
Yeah.
Hard rock.
Mm-hmm.
When I listen to your band, am I way off here?
It's rock. I think it's a hard thing. Rock and roll is so many definitions of what rock and roll is. It's a wide spectrum. So, what do you think?
Well, Hendrix is better than some things we get.
Yeah, Hendrix is definitely a compliment.
Yeah.
But then again, he played some blues songs, but he really wasn't a blues player. I mean, he was blues influenced, but psychedelic and that whole thing.
So. The music, using those guys as a base, using the guys from Double Trouble as the base of the band, and then you two are sort of the icing on the cake, how's the music the Archangels are making different than what Stevie Ray Vaughan did?
Well, he was playing blues songs the way he plays, which is very hard and very long and, you know, and very good, but... And we're playing songs, really, that, like, we wrote.
Yeah, it's a little more stress on the songwriting aspect of things.
When I was listening to the CD, my God, it went on and on and on. There's almost an hour of music on this.
12 songs. We sort of, and that we cut it down a lot from there. We had a lot of songs to choose from, and there was just this discrepancy between these two songs we couldn't lose, you know. So we just give you more for your money, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. Bang for your buck. The way you guys wrote the songs, how did that work?
Pretty sporadically. The song that really started the band was Living a Dream, the first single. And Dole had that song for several years, right?
4 years.
Yeah, just in pieces. And he brought it to me. And I went back to my studio and we talked about it and pieced it all together. And that really defined the basic sound of the band. And then we just diversified from that. And did a lot of writing with a gentleman named Tony O'Kay, who I've been working with for a long time.
Is it a difficult process for you to write songs? I mean, to me, when you write a song and to not finish it in 4 years seems that you start songs and you just your personal thing is that you find it difficult to finish them off? Or?
No. I just have like a lot of ideas, and maybe I've had ideas for a lot of years, and it's like, I mean, you can't always finish them. I'm not going to sit there and force it out of me,
yeah.
You know? That's what I don't like to do when I'm songwriting. If I have to force it, then I stop and like try to go on to something else.
Huh?
Just let it come out naturally, you know.
And for you, when you look back or listen back to your old record or see an old video, how do you feel?
To be really honest with you, it achieved what I wanted to achieve, was to open up the spectrum of what people thought of me. From making that record, that first record that I did, I could basically make any kind of music that I wanted. I wasn't pigeonholed as a blues musician or all these other things that people somehow perceived, you know. But when you think about it again, a lot of my writing is like modern blues, because a lot of it is very emotional and very, some of it's more lyrics, not a whole lot of positive stuff, but it's real, so hopefully.
When you listen to the lyrics of your old album, does it bring back memories of a certain era?
Yeah, it does, definitely.
What were you going through at that time?
I
mean, you were 17 years old, 16 years old.
Mm-hmm.
You were a kid in a grown-up world.
Yeah, well, I think we both were kids in grown-up worlds almost from conception, you know, because we didn't really grow up with the white picket fence and Ward and June Cleaver, you know.
And you were both touring around in bands when you were 13 years old?
No, I mean, I was touring around with my dad, but I wasn't playing. I was just watching him play, really.
So when did you actually start to make money or go out with bands and perform?
When I was 15, I guess. I started playing on the weekends, working a job in the week.
Yeah. So your dad's some hot player, huh?
Yeah.
So tell us about your dad.
What?
Tell me about your dad.
He's a songwriter, singer. He can pick a little guitar.
Would that be an understatement, picking a little guitar?
No.
No, he's
primarily a drummer.
Yeah. No, he's
and
a great singer.
Yeah.
He's one of my favorite singers. And he wrote a lot of songs on all of Stevie's albums. He's the only person Stevie really collaborated with songwriting.
For you to be part of this band, and I know that before the band started, you were working on some solo material. What did you have to give up in order to get? You always have to give up to get something.
Yeah,
you got a band. What'd you give up?
I gave up maybe a little of the control, a little of the limelight, things like that. But I'm not worried about the vain aspects of it. I'm worried about the music and putting out the best stuff that I can, you know, and writing the best songs that I can at this point in my life. And it's all a real growing process and evolution, sort of.
And I guess in the same vein, Dole, when you talk about putting the band together, one of the intentions was to split everything down the middle and everybody to do little bits of everything. But the reality of the world is that people have very strong personalities, and sometimes it doesn't always work out that way.
Well, yeah, so I mean, when we say split it down the middle, it's between Dole and I, because we're the main vocalists and stuff like that, and, you know.
Did it work?
I think it did. I think it came out that way.
We try not to, like, split it down the middle, like, you do this much, and then I'll do this other half.
Yeah.
And, I mean, if you do that, then you lose, you know, what we're all about or whatever. So, I mean, we just pretty much got in a room. If Charlie would bring in a song, you know, he'd say, here's how it goes and stuff. And then, like, if I happened to play a lead on it in while we were there, you know.
And,
that's what happens. So, or vice versa. Whatever happens when we just play.
You checked
song.
Your ego at the front door, kind of thing.
Somewhat, yeah. But then again, I'm Irish, so I
What is it about Texas and the blues? Why are such fantastic bluesmen coming out of Texas?
I don't know.
I mean, a lot of people of the original blues musicians that started this whole thing are from there. I mean, like Albert Collins is a little later in the food chain of blues, I guess, but Lightnin' Hopkins is from there.
Freddie King,
yeah. I mean, there's just a lot, you know, a lot of it came from there. So maybe it's just in the water, maybe it's in the air, maybe it's, I don't know. It's got a lot of soul in Texas, you know?
Also, it's like a melting pot of the blues, because, like, Texas took Chicago and the Delta and everywhere and put it all into one.
Created their own thing. Yeah. Which is sort of what we've done, too, as a band, you know, is take all these different influences. You know, Stevie, the Double Trouble aspect with Chris and Tommy, bring a certain something to it, Dover, and I'd bring something else to it.
And 12 songs. Yeah. Goes on for an hour, I'll tell you. This is the CD. It's beautiful. Beautiful cover. Very nice.
Did that myself.
So, you did. You lied to me. You're going to be performing here soon. Do you know when?
I think it's June 16th at the Spectrum.
Sorry. And are you going to any other Canadian cities, or is it just one Canadian
date? Montreal on the 14th of
June. Oh, good. Okay. Well, thanks very much. Maybe you'll come back and visit us again.
Of course we will.
We have your video for you. And for everybody out there watching, it's Living in a Dream. This is the first song that you guys collaborated on, and it's really what started off the Archangels.
Starting point.
All right. Well, thanks very much. Best of luck. And this is Living in a Dream, Archangels. How much?
Living in a dream.